Welcome to presentation, students. Today we are going to learn about graphic representation of the data. In the previous class, we have studied the representation of the data on one-dimensional and two-dimensional diagrams. So in previous class, we have studied the diagrams like a rectangle diagram, circular diagrams, and also the ball diagrams. Here we are going to study about the graph by using lines and curves, how we are going to present the same data in by using graph. So first of all, we should know the distinction between diagrams and graph, because same data can be shown in in diagram, as well as the same data can be shown in graph. In diagrams, we use the geometrical designs or geometrical shapes like a circular, bars, rectangles to show the data. But in case of diagrams, graph, we are using lines, curves to show the same data. That is a major difference between the graph and diagram. So, ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ನಾವು ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರಲ್ಲಿ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಡೇಟಾನ ಹೇಗೆ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅನ್ನೋ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ವಿ. ಅದು ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನ್, ಟೂ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಸೇಮ್ ಡೇಟಾನ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಾಫನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅನ್ನೋ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. So first, we have to make a distinction between graph and diagram. That we have already studied in the first chapter itself. Diagrams, in diagrams we use the geometrical shapes. Andre diagrams alli geometrical shapes anna tagondo data present maadidive, like we have used bars, circles, rectangles, ee taradanna use maadkondo naavu presentation maadidre. Illi graph alli we are using the lines, curves, points to show the that same data. That is the major distinction. So alli designs, that is shapes ana use maarkotivi, illi points athwa lines athwa curves kul moolka the data na present maartivi. That is a major distinction between the graph and diagrams. Next, there are two type of graphs. First one is a graph of time series, that is nothing but a line graph. This can be also we have going to study it in the last chapter. And second one is graph of frequency distribution, that what we have already studied in the frequency, that frequency can be shown in the graph through graph also, like a median, mode, and then the quartiles as well as the histograms, all can be shown in the frequency, that is in a graph. So the such type of graphs are called as frequency graph. So next, come to what are those type of graphs can also be used to make the prediction and forecast. That means here graphs, by using graph we can predict the future data also. Suppose we are given the data of last 10 years, we can predict the data for the next year also. That is a major advantage of graph. Graph alli suppose namge data previous years kottidre mundina varshagalanna kuda estimate maadabodu, adu ondu major advantage antu heltivi. Now we are going to study about the types of graphs. First type is line graph. Graphs are erdu method alli helide, frequency graph, line graph. Frequency graph andre frequency distributions anna hege graph moolaka torustivi adana frequency graph antu heltivi. Like histogram torisbodu, frequency polygon, frequency curve, cumulative frequency of polygon athwa ogives anthe heltivi. ಅದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ಮೀಡಿಯನ್, ಮೋಡು, ಈ ತರದ್ದೆಲ್ಲದನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಆರ್ ಲೈನ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಆರ್ ಇಸ್ಟಿಯೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಸ್ಟೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇಸ್ಟಿಯೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಬೇರೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಇಸ್ಟೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಅಂತಾನು ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಗ್ರಾಫ್. ಎ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ with more, that is what are the advantage and limitations. First, graph is more attractive and impressive than the tables. Whatever the data we are shown in the table, they are not rememberable. That is why it is more impressive than the graph table. That means graph is more attractive and it is impressive also. With the help of graph, comparison between the two or more phenomena can be made easy, because we can present a one diagram for the maximum data also. As a result, it is possible to compare the two or more diagram and arrive at the result. Since the data become visible at a glance in a graph, one can understand it easily and can study the tendency and fluctuation of the data. So visibly there, that means attractive agirutte, and then now future data kuda predict maadabodu anta helidini graph anna use maadkondo. That is also a major advantage. And then graphs are also helpful in interpretation, extrapolation and forecasting. That is nothing but estimations alli useful agide. That the two series can be studied easily with the help of graph. That means here two or more graphs anna one day diagrams alli athwa two time series anna present madabodu. Andre iga take for example one line 10 varshuddan torsodre one type alli, adhe taradalli innond line bekadre 20 varshuddu torsta hogbodu. That is a major advantage. These are the advantages of the graphic representation. Limitation: graph may be misused by taking the false scale. That means suppose you can take the scale, that is any scale, automatically we are going to get the different data. So therefore illi namge misuse aagta ide athwa misrepresentation aagta ide graph. Next, accuracy is rather not possible in graph because it is completely based on how we are going to take the scale. So if you take the scale, we'll get a different answer automatically. Accuracy is like perfect accuracy in formula hak madadaga yen sigutte aste amount nam sigdale irbodu. Graph cannot be quoted in support of this statement. Graph anna quote mad thosslikagala. This is also one of the disadvantage anthe helthivi. These are the limitations of the graph. Next come to what are the types: graph, histograms, hysterograms. That means line graph. This is line graph and this is frequency graph. There, what are the types of frequency graphs? That is also given here. This is the types. Let us come to introduction to graph. So now we are going to the problematic part. Before going to problematic part, first we must give an information, a brief information regarding the graph. Suppose if we draw the two perpendicular lines at the 90 degree, andre eradu lines anna 90 degree nalli draw madidre namage we are going to get that is point. This point is called as an origin, and we can divide the quadrant into four part: first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth. Andre eradu line ana intersect aago tara neevu draw maadadaga nimage illi intersect point sigutte. This is called as a zero point anta heltivi. Ee zero point alli ನಮಗೆ ಇಂಟರ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ರೀಜನ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಇದು ಆರಿಜನ್ಗೆ ಈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಶೀಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಭಾಗವಾಗಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆರಿಜನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್. What is the sign of this quadrant? This is always plus plus. Andre avaglu represent the x point, this is y point. First number is always x, second number is always y. This is x point and this is y point. Andre suppose both are in positive, we can point this point here. Eradu numbers point eradu positive agidre eradu point ee quadrant alli athwa ee bhagadalli barutte anta heltivi. Suppose see here minus 6 minus 4 or sir plus 4 andre x minus negative ide y positive ide anta cases alli ee part barutte. Suppose both are negative, that means x is also negative, y is also negative, then it comes here point. And similarly here, suppose x is positive, y is negative, then this one. That means here this is plus plus, idu plus plus, and this is minus and plus, this is minus minus, here this is plus and minus. These are the sign of the quadrant anta heltivi. Suppose 6 6 nodi 6 here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 here, and then 4 1 2 3 4 5 6 4 here, this point, this is here and this is here. This point is called as first point, second point here, 1 2 3 4 6 minus 6 and then plus a plus 4, and this minus 6 plus 4, this point, if you connect this way, we are going to get a what you call as rectangles. So this is a brief introduction regarding the graph. Next come to variety of time series graph. What do you mean time series graph or line graph? A curve showing a changes in the value of one or more items from one period to period of time to next is known as graph of time series. A curve showing changes in the value of one or more item from one period to period of time to next is known as graph of time series. Graph of time series andre now periodical graph anna adu 10 15 varshada data iddaga adu neen present martivi, that type of graphs are called as time series graphs or line graph. Graph showing the changes in the value of one or more item from one period to time to next time, it is known as graph of time series. Andre one 10 varshu data, 10 varshu data na 10 beginning alli istitu 10th year alli istitu ivereddu data nu nodlikke sagutte sadhya agutte, that type of graphs are called as time series. This curve is also called as hysterogram. Hysterogram because history anth helthivi aa tara previous figures anna torsuvantadu. So these are the type of, this can be shown for the changes in price, production, import, population, etc. idanna elli upayogisthivi andre yavadadru one variable alli difference anna neevu torisbeku andre ee graphs anna use madabodu. Let us start with the line graph. First problem, a line graph is useful for displaying the data or information that changes continuously over time. So over a time, what will be the change in a particular data, that can be recorded by the time graph or line graph that I have already explained. Okay, another name for the line graph is line chart. So now let us take up the first problem. Car sales of a showroom for 6 months period is as follows. Show the result through the line graph or time graph. See here, the sales of a particular showroom is given for a 6 months period from January to June. So sales, it may be for 20 units, 30, 20, 35 units, 25 units, 40 units. So like this, the showroom has sold the number of cars in a particular 6 months period that has been given, that has to be shown in a line graph. See the first one, minimum is 20, maximum is 45. This is the values, and then here always on the x-axis we have to show the time. Time series graph alli yavaglu x-axis mele time anna torisbeku. Yavudu number anna athwa values kottidare adanna yavaglu y-axis mele torso. This is a basic condition always we should follow. X-axis represented the time. Time anna, because it is a time graph athwa time series graph, it always represent the time. Here athwa time en kottidane adanna yavaglu x-axis mele kodi. There are 6 months January, that is 1 inch graph athwa 2 inch. I have taken a 2 inch or 1 inch, 1 inch graph, that is here 1 inch, here one, that rate alli tagondide. 1 inch is equal to 1 month, this is second month, third month, like that we have mentioned the months on x-axis. Y-axis include the number of cars sold. Here minimum scale and maximum scale, minimum is 20, maximum is 45. So 1 inch is equal to 5. I have taken 1 inch is equal to 5, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, like that. Maximum is 45, that is why full name here 50, up to 50 I have taken. In the month of January, 20 cars are sold out. Therefore, here 20 for the first point it is. For the month of January, the February, that is 35 units are sold. So we locate the second point. In the month of March, there are about 25 units are sold. So this is a third point, and this is fourth point, fifth point. In the month of May, maximum 45 units are sold. This is a May month point, and this is June. There is a decline in the sales, that is 30 units are sold in the month of June. Therefore, when we draw this way, when we connect these point, we are going to get a line. This line is called as line graph or time series line. Time series line, it is indicate what is the, that is what is the difference from January to June in the sales of a showroom cars. So it indicate it, there may be increase in the trend, but there may be decrease in the month of June. So this is a called as zigzag line. It is not a straight line. It comes like this way, zigzag line. Ups and downs are shown in this graph. So this is one variety, one type of graph. Next come to another graph, that is if this is a information given from 1995 to 2002. So values are given 5, 5, 7, 10. These are the year wise data is given here. Year wise data here, there is a maximum is 12, minimum is 5 values to be shown. So here has to be taken on x-axis, values are to be taken on y-axis. So what is the minimum value? 5. What is the maximum value? 12. So that is why 1 inch is equal to 2. I have taken the scale, 1 inch is equal to 2. 2, next is 4, 6, 8. That is in the multiples of 2 it is going. So in the year for 95, the sales is, or value is 5. In the month, in the year 96, value is 7. It in the month 97, in the year 97, it is 10. Like that, it is going like this. So when we are connect these point, we are going to get a line. So this is called as line graph. It can be shown in any type, but remember, always connect the point by using, that is, scale. It is not a freehand curve. You have to use the scale to connect the points. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಹಾಕೋತಿರ ಮೊದಲು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕೊಂಡ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇವುಗಳನ್ನ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಇದು ಫ್ರೀ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಕರ್ವ್ ಅನ್ನಲ್ಲ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬರೀ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಬರೀತಾ ಹೋಗೋದಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಕರ್ವ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಆಗಿ, ಅದೇ ಲೈನ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತಾ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಈ ತರ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೆರೈಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಗ್ರಾಫ್. ಇನ್ ದಿ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟಿ. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಹಿಸ್ಟೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬೈ ಹಿಸ್ಟೋಗ್ರಾಮ್? A histogram consists of set of rectangles. This is the word, set of rectangles, like a set of multiple multiple diagrams hege madidivi adhe tara here set of rectangles having base on a horizontal axis, that is x axis. Note that these base are marked off by class boundaries, not the class limit. Class boundaries anna le madbeku, class limits melalla, with center, that is class intervals nodkobeku, class intervals mention madbeku, class limit alla, with center at the class marks and areas proportional to class frequency. These are all shown in the frequency, don't worry, go through it. Always x axis mele barbeku diagram. So this is a set of rectangles. This is a definition of histogram. Histogram consists of set of rectangles having a base on horizontal axis. So set of rectangles. Now set means group. Set of rectangles that we are going to show in a graph, that is considered as histogram, or this is based on the class interval. So that is why it is called as frequency graph. If the class interval sizes are equal, then the height of the rectangle is also proportional to class frequency and are taken numerically equal to class frequency. So equal class frequency iddag hege madbeku adanna na workout madana. If the class interval sizes are not equal, then heights of the rectangle have to be adjusted. Suppose class intervals we have already know, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, like this. If there is a class intervals are equal, no need to adjust here. That is the concept here, it is explained. So height of the rectangles are equal to class frequency. Class frequency ಎಷ್ಟು ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅದ್ರ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಹೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ಈಕ್ವಲ್, ಟೇಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಅನ್ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ 10 to 20, ಬಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ 20 to 40. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯರ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಈಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ 10, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ 20. ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಕೇಸಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ದಿ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಶೋನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೆಥಡ್? First method, equal class interval. So I am going to draw the equal class interval. Draw x-axis and y-axis. The y-axis and x-axis, take the class boundaries on x-axis, frequencies on y-axis. This remember how we are shown the on x-axis the time. Similarly, in case of frequency graph, ali line graph ali hege time ana x-axis mel torsudvi, illi x-axis mele yavaglu class intervals ana torsbeku. Class intervals always mentioned on x-axis and frequencies are always shown on y-axis. Construct the joint rectangles, that is joint or set of rectangles. Joint, that is not a, that is separate bars, it is a set of bars. Adrindalli joint rectangles ant heltivi. The resulting figure is the histogram. Let us see how it is drawn. See here, construct histogram from the following frequency distribution. So here, construction of the histogram, you refer the class interval. This is nothing but a exclusive or inclusive class intervals. See here, 40 to 49, 50 to 59, there is no continuity. Okay, there is no continuity in the class interval, so we have to make them continuous because these are exclusive agilla. Idu inclusive class interval agide. Exclusive andre enagiruttade 40 to 50 agutte, and next 50 to 60, 60 to 70 ee tara irthittu, but ill class interval inclusive agide. There is no ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇರಿಸಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಕರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಫಿಗರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಅಥವಾ ಕರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಹೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್? ಕರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ 50 minus 49, how much? 1. 1 divided by 2, that is 1 divided by 2 is equal to what? 0.5. That should be subtracted from this first, the lower limit, that should be added to upper level. Therefore, 39.5, 49.5. Next, what is the difference between these two terms? Again, 60 minus 59, 1. 1 divided by 2, 0.5. 0.5 should be subtracted here. Therefore, 49.5, 59.5. So, this is the method of showing class boundaries or continuous series or the inclusive frequencies. If the inclusive frequencies are given, then we have to convert them into exclusive. And next, how we are going to construct? See here, so what is the first one? That is class boundaries. Mark the class boundaries along the x-axis and y-axis. So 39.5 to 49.5. So 39. First bar, that is 39.5 to 49. This is the first bar. Okay, class interval 39.5, 39.5 to 49.5. So this is first bar. What is the measurement? 1. So values, maximum frequency is 5, minimum frequency is 1. So therefore, maximum we have to show on y-axis 5. So R6, whatever it may be, up to 5 we are going to mark. This is first class interval, this is second class interval, third class interval. So we have given the class interval here, class interval, this is frequency. So this is first class interval. What is the value of the frequency here? 1. What is the value of the second part? That is 49.5 to 59.5, that is here. 59.5, that is 3. So these are all joint rectangles. So it is not, that is, in a rectangle we give a space from one bar to another bar. Here there is no space, just in a group or in a set we have to draw the, according to, first look at the values, frequencies here, and then class intervals here. So first class interval 1 centimeter, second class 1 centimeter, thirds like that, we have to mention the class interval. This figure, whatever we are going to get, this is one complete. That means for this point to this boundary of this class interval is up to this 39.5 to 49.5. That's why this bar represents this. Here 49.5 to 59.5. This bar represents the, that is how much is 3. What about the third one? 59 to 69.5. What is the, that is frequency? How much is the frequency? How much is frequency? Here, this is the frequency histogram. So this is first class problem. Next, come to another problem. Draw the histogram from the following data. Here, 10 frequency is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, like this. So this is the frequency class interval. This is exclusive class interval. No need to, that is, rearrange, because here the problem is in inclusive series. That is why it has been arranged. Yeah, But here we have arranged the class interval, but here the class intervals are already exclusive, but here it is inclusive. That is why we have arranged the data. Here the problems are not exclusive, it is already exclusive, no need to arrange. Just draw the frequencies on this curve. Highest frequency is 65, that's why commence with the maximum, 12 is the minimum. That is why take the first data 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So this is the highest bar, this is the highest bar. And then 12, this is 12, this is 32, 38, 65, 45, 25 and 12. This set is considered, this is drawn by using Excel sheet in the on computer based diagram. Andre already helidini graphs ana use madbekare athwa diagrams ana use madbekare we can use X, that is computer, by using the Excel sheet ana use maadkondu graph diagram hakkodu thumba easy. So that is a major advantage, adli advantage matte attractive agi kanuste. Suppose if you give this data, automatically we are going to get this format. Ee data kottu hige class interval and frequency kottaga automatically diagram bartha hogutte. So how we can draw the histogram by using that is computer, that is also consider here. So this is the information that we have discussed today in the graph. Now I am concluding the class. Before conclusion, what we have studied so far, let us recap that. In this session, we learn the graphical representation of the data. There are two type of graphical representation of the data: time series graph and frequency graph. Time series graph shown changes in the variable over a period. Andre illi navu eradu taradanna study madidvi, and ondu time series graph adanna already eradu problems anna workout madidvi. Ade tara frequency graphs tagondaga first one eradu problem histograms mele work madidivi. So therefore we have covered four problems in this session. Frequency graph show the grouping variable information. Grouping variable means frequency distribution anna torsutte frequency graph. Here we showed the histogram ana to inclusive class al bandu workout madide, exclusive class al bandu workout madide. First if you consider the exclusive, it is easy, and then if the problem is in inclusive, then how it is to be worked out, that is also shown in the session. Okay, now I am going to conclude. Thank you.